My beloved ones, I greet you now in an entirely new location in time and space, and in greater awareness of the unified field which you are and which is an extension of you. Today I wish to share with you some of the amazing liberty available to you in this innate state of being, wholeness. In the wholeness the mind harmonizes with the heart. During this past year, there has been a huge focus on reorienting you to your heart. This was necessary for balance in the progressive movement toward wholeness. So many of you had for years lived primarily within your minds that reorienting you to the heart was critical to facilitating a felt sense of unity and the desire to be love. Now, beyond the October 10th, 10 Stargate, we have emerged into a domain of wholeness. Within wholeness, we reclaim the vital and beautiful aspect of the mind, incorporating and aligning it in harmonious balance with the heart. Mental focus is a requirement for clarity and function. It is not possible to have a productive and happy human life without learning to make peace with your mind. Your mind, and your thinking capabilities give form to your energy. They organize and synthesize your experience. The awareness you experience exists in part through your mind's ability to discern what information to share and make present to you. As you cultivate your relationship to your mind, like a TiVo box on the TV, learns what programs you prefer and starts to orient around your preferences. This is the wonderful, adaptive, and amazing powers of your mental faculty and your mind. Thinking is an important and highly creative aspect of the human experience. Now that you have reconnected with an orientation to oneness, to unity, and have opened your hearts to expect and flow and be love, your mind will participate in your creative life in an entirely new way. Opening of the new doorways to prosperity within your experience. Many of you lack much of what you desire in terms of material things, and the financial resources to choose and create lifestyle experiences which you feel strongly would bring you happiness and peace. In this enlightening time, it's important to begin to qualify your sense of lack by questioning how this relates to the innate oneness you now believe is. I challenge you in this way because you are ready. For in oneness you are not separated from anything. Separation exists only as a mindset, an emotional and even a mental habit or pattern. Belief in or living from a perspective of separation makes experiencing financial and material abundance or prosperity difficult to impossible for many of you. The new earth is not a place which simply caters to entitlement. Being light workers does not mean that you suddenly become magnetic to things which are not a vibrational match to your emotional beliefs and patterns. You experience what is a match for your energy. You are not rewarded in life for being light workers. The new earth will not solve all of this by magically taking away the experience of money, nor by releasing you from the incredibly fun and joyful experience of aligning with that which you desire and discovering your power. That would be insulting to you. And although you may say, "No, Archangel Michael, I would be relieved. Trust me, please just bring it on, that prosperity experience. It will not come into your experience in this way." Now that I've directly spoken to these lingering illusions, let's explore wholeness and unity as it relates to money in some depth. I intend to share with you, to remind you of ideas that you may use to allow the true nature of reality to flow freely within your experience and loosen up and release your amazing energy. Smile. First of all, you are free and powerful. You are one with all that is and live as a particularized aspect of source energy or the unified field in the focus of this spiritual energy embodied in your human life experience. To treat you as though you cannot master this is to deny your innate divinity. Creating money and turning the keys to abundance on the earth plane is a shift which you can experience most easily in small steps. The part of you that embraces and nurtures a scenario in which there is a sudden shift and everything in your life in this way is immediately and suddenly resolved is a debilitating intention for most of you, and ironically puts an enormous amount of pressure on you, rather than improving your experience. Very few humans are able to align with such an enormous shift and change. It is far easier to make small changes, see movement, be uplifted and inspired and create again with this momentum, more. I am here to encourage you to claim your power, which for starters means realizing if you are not yet experiencing material and financial abundance, and you wish to, then begin by considering you might revise your understanding of this from, "It doesn't exist," or "In the new earth there won't be any money," to something a bit more accurate in our omniverse comprised entirely of energy, you are not yet a match for what you desire. You may have ideas how. You may have heard things and tried things. But essentially, if you aren't living it, you don't yet consciously know how to get in sync with it. So for starters, what if you realized this, with complete love and affection and instead begin to learn remember realize what will get you in sync? What if you acknowledged, that no matter how old you are, how enlightened you are, how many lifetimes you've lived, how spiritual or good you are that perhaps, there are some wonderful and amazing things you might learn, locally, or truthfully remember, non-locally, which would shift all of this financial stuff more toward what you'd enjoy. I know some of you are already learning and practicing, and those who are have had moments of insight, moments of suddenly having more money, or things come to them effortlessly and freely even. The experience of the floodgates opening when one comes into alignment with what they intend and create immediately in form, so you know what I mean. I speak for a moment here directly and personally to those who are honestly, deeply tortured by financial experiences in their life. Who experience profound stress, self-hatred, and pain even based on their relationship to money. As a result, you often find yourself angry with those who charge money or seemingly too much money for that which you want. You feel critical and express negative energy to those who do this. You find yourself looking at wealthy people and finding all kinds of things wrong with them, and I tell you, my beloved ones, you are that. You are the wealthy person. Innately. So if you criticize them, you criticize you. And then, that part of you cannot come forth freely in your experience. It lurks in your shadow, angry and unexpressed. It comes forth in resentment toward those who are in the flow of prosperity or abundance to one degree or another, and instead of observing and noticing how these people live as a way of learning what of that might speak to you directly and seeing how you might begin to live with a mindset more like theirs, you create a separation between you and them. And in this separation, you also separate yourself from your own financial abundance. Years ago there was a great writer who spoke that you were meant to experience everything which you were capable of appreciating. This is indeed true. This does not mean that since you have that potential, these experiences will flow to you without you coming into alignment with this truth. This again would rob you of your own power. So let's refresh our memory as to what we've remembered together and celebrated over this past year or so about our beautiful universe. For hasn't this past year revealed you and deepened your appreciation of some of the key themes of the universe and indeed of the present human condition? Unity. Harmony and balance. Love. Oneness. Multidimensionality. Completion. Divinity. All of these qualities are innately you. And as many of you have experienced firsthand getting into sync with these qualities, allowing them to flow into all aspects of you and your experience, has taken some major effort and has been physically, emotionally, and mentally challenging. You have to let go of a great deal to get there, don't you? And you do this so well. To extend this, the same is true with the quality of prosperity. To claim the financial abundance which is yours, you have to let go of issues/contrary ideas you have with wealth. With wealthy people. With money. With charging money. With asking for money for your work. Oh my. Yes, I really said that. You see? So many of you don't really like yourselves that much. You don't realize that first of all money, is just a form of energy. It's a resource. It's just energy. And it flows and flows and flows into all kinds of situations and forms, and just like energy sometimes it gets stuck and that creates problems, and sometimes there is resistance to it and that creates problems. And as long as you trust it and use it and love it and play with it, and don't hold on, but open to receive, and allow yourself to ask for it and want it, and let it flow freely without fear, it will work fine for you. But you only get as much as you deserve. And guess what? You decide what you deserve. So perhaps you ought to do some serious internal inquiry as to why, if you're not experiencing the prosperity you wish, you think for some reason now, right now you don't deserve it. And it will likely come down to either not loving yourself enough and/or not believing you're enough just as you are and/or thinking you have to do something to make it happen and that something is always out in the future. It's never now or here. Well, all of this is just getting you nowhere but unhappy. So I ask you. May I please come forth and simply show you another way? Open up some doors by making peace with money and everything about it. Make this as important as making peace with unity and love and oneness as sending energy to heal the Gulf of Mexico or support the earth. I tease you with love, my dear ones. You react to these comments because there is still duality in your belief system. You still have some beliefs and patterns of living which are rooted in the concept of separateness and a lack of worthiness. Realize all the value judgment that exists still in your experience. There is a lot of it on earth and it will take some time and some doing to release the charge of it by including everything in your experience as something you can love and appreciate, and realizing you are not separate from wealth or anything. So for starters, let's just be beginners. You've just met money for the first time. I am showing it to you. Look. Here is this amazing energy form which you can use to create things in your life. You can use it to pay for lumber for your new doghouse. You can use it to buy a pizza. You can use it to create labels for your new essential healing oils. You can use it to buy a new computer monitor so you can write without your eyes getting tired. You can use it to pay for LASIK surgery so you can open your eyes underwater and see when you're swimming. Now, let's consider the another side of the game. What would you like to do and be during the day? Do you want to read? Talk to people. Make things with your hands. Create rituals. Play with your kids. Would you like to learn how to heal broken bones? How to create pastries? How to advise people on making career changes? To help people as they prepare to die? Whatever you would enjoy learning, being, doing, imagine that being a way you receive money. If you'd like to receive money from this. If not, imagine how you'd like to receive money. But be careful here, take small steps and don't violate other people's free choice. For example, decide what you'd like to do for work and if it's with others in an organized setting, then ask to be guided to it and pay attention. Tell people you know what you're looking for. Expect it to show up. Find ways to start living and being in that mode already. Tell money you love it. And if you don't love it, you're disconnected from money somehow. All forms of separation in thinking and behavior limit your innate divine creative power. Money is an energy which allows you to exchange, affirm, and create experiences you value. Money is another way you express appreciation for that which you value and which gives you joy. Like that beautiful haircut which makes you feel so handsome. Or that spa treatment that turns all of your muscles into noodles. Or that dinner with your daughter to celebrate her piano recital and treat her to a luxurious experience as she enters young adulthood. Or that animal shelter which helps to find homes for dogs that you love knowing exists and want to make sure is thriving. Money helps you create in the world. It's energy. Just like focus. Just like attention. It's just energy. So for starters, make peace with money. Then make peace with people who make money. Make peace with people who charge money. And really make peace with people who make lots and lots of money, because it shows you that it's an option if you want it. Be appreciative for the idea. And begin to see if you can embrace the mindset of someone who has money. The freedom to make choices, to do things, to create things, to have experiences, to live with ease and focus on creating and expressing, on loving and learning, on understanding and thinking and inventing and transforming and knowing aliveness. The sense of expecting to have the ability to choose freely more and more to your liking. Take this seriously and begin. Accept that learning to master the keys to prosperity, and release all that stands in your way, is gonna take up your focus for a while. And it ought to. To get yourself to a place where that part of life is ironed out a bit is important, for it will give you a platform which you all desire, from which to create and express yourselves. The size of this energy flow will vary. Some prefer more, some prefer less. But most of you are still learning how to allow in what you prefer. And that, my dear friends, is what I'd like you to claim as the next theme for 2010 that you will master. So unity and balance and harmony and oneness and love and alignment and expansion and multidimensionality and divinity are all extended by prosperity and wealth. And the other thing which is very helpful is physical well-being. So you see, the new human is emerging in a way you perhaps did not anticipate. Ascension is not a one-moment event. Ascension happens continually. It's an ascending energy arc you want to be riding on, living on, attuned with, as often as possible. The new human has resolved the duality of the past. In the past, spiritual pursuits were not very integrated with mastering commerce and money. Spirituality was pursued as though it was separate from money, and religion was often the path, and yet that often was separate from any concept of energy. So much of the old paradigms involved separating things: sex from holiness, money from spirituality, goodness from financial aspirations. All of these old paradigms were based on separateness. We're all about oneness now, and inclusiveness and unity. Not because we think these are nice ideas, but because we know that reality is one, interconnected, expanding, diversifying energetic field. So let's get on with mastering that which will allow each of you beautiful beings to diversify the universe with the specificity which is yours alone. That's your role here, to create newness. So the new human might meditate, get a facial, work with homeless people, drink martinis, live in a city, be divorced, channel angels, have memories of being abducted, willingly, on a spaceship for upgrades and teachings. The new human is as diverse and beautiful and complex and unique as the Earth is. And all the ways you hope ascension will remove things that you have not yet mastered is also an old paradigm which says that you don't have power and need to be rescued by something, and ascension is not about rescuing you. It's about each of you finding your own limitless point of creativity and alignment and flowing it. And inspiring others by your example. And activating their codes with your expansion. And collectively creating phenomenal, already unstoppable momentum. It's something you create. It's entirely about your amazing power. And finding it and flowing it and enjoying it. Ascension is about unity. And the entire experience is about a club which welcomes everyone, everything, and all ways of doing it. It's a lot to get your head around, isn't it? That's why you have a heart. It opens and lets everything in. Very naturally. It's made for it. I will continue to remind you, support you, challenge you, in any ways in which you ask. I am available to you in all ways, and especially at this time, as it relates to work, love, money, health, hope, clarity, and ultimately energy. The ascending energy will take you everywhere you want to go, but, you gotta ride it. You gotta let it surface things within you to clear the way for the new, really fabulous stuff. And you have to welcome it. Ascension isn't going to override your own belief system. Your belief system will simply weigh down the arc a bit, and you'll look up to see people riding high like you'd like. You can join them at any time if that's your preference. Just throw a few things out of your ship. Lighten the load, people. That's all. It's all yours anyway, in this amazing, endless wholeness.